Hello students of standard 8. In geography, you are learning about disasters. Today you are going to learn chapter 5, disasters, part 3. In part 3, you are going to learn about natural disasters. Floods. What is flood? When there is overflow of rivers. Or there is very heavy rainfall and a large low-lying area due to the overflowing of rivers get flooded. So here there are two types of floods, riverine floods and flash floods. Riverine floods takes place in the rivers when the river water get flooded or overflow. There is flood or water in the low-lying areas along with the river. And what is flash floods? It takes place all at sudden when there is very heavy rainfall or there is dam destructed due to the earthquake, or if there is landslide, these flash floods take place. If you see in the parts of India, our country, there are some rivers which are famous for their flood. Every year floods come and that area is being destroyed. Like river Ganga, when river Koshi gets flooded, the volume of water also increases in river Ganga. River Brahmaputra also gets flooded in rainy season or monsoon season. Here in Jharkhand, river Damodar is also known as Soro of West Bengal. Also in Jharkhand. And Koshi, river Koshi is known as the Soro of Bihar. So like that, when there is very heavy rainfall, some rivers get flooded. And when there is melting of glaciers on Himalayas, sometimes all of a sudden the volume of river water increases and there is flood. So in India, the northern part of India, northeastern part of India, is affected due to the flood. How to cope with this flood? Coping with floods. By evacuating people and livestock on time, setting up temporary shelters, stocking food, water and medicines, and keeping boats and communication equipment ready. If it is well prepared before the commencement of flood, if the area is flood prone zone, or the people are living along with the rivers when flood comes, this preparation can be done and that can reduce the suffering and damage of life and property. And also, during the flood, people should not touch the electronic things. They should turn off the electricity to prevent short circuits. During the flood, there may be chances of spreading of different diseases due to the water which is contaminated, full of impurities. So people are asked to use or drink boiled water during the flood so that they can be protected themselves from different diseases like diarrhea. And also during this flood season or after flood, spread bleaching powder or some other medicines to get rid from some of the insects which are spread over that area. So that can reduce some of the sufferings. The next natural disaster is cyclones. There are two types of cyclones: tropical cyclones and temperate cyclones. Tropical cyclones are more destructive than the temperate cyclones. Here some examples are given, as they are known as hurricanes in western Atlantic. Also they are known as typhoons in western Pacific and Willy Willys in Australia. In our country, the tropical cyclone originates over Bay of Bengal. And when there is depression over Bay of Bengal, swirling motion of the cyclonic wind carries too much moisture and oceanic water. All at sudden struck the coastal region in the southern and eastern coast of India, and that is very much destructive. So due to the depression over Bay of Bengal, the coast of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Orissa and West Bengal, these are badly affected. When there is depression sometimes over Arabian Sea, parts of Gujarat and western coast can be affected due to this cyclone. During cyclone, all at sudden the tides rise, and due to that there are two types of stormy winds and cyclones: storm surges and storm tides. Storm surges are the whole like very high sea waves like tsunami, and the storm tides, which is high tide, that increases and strikes at the coast and very badly affect and disrupt the coastal regions. So when there is cyclone, if there are some forested areas on the coast, it can be reduced. The speed of the wind or the destructive power can be reduced if there are forested areas. So when there is cyclone, how to cope with the cyclone? Sometimes warning is given before the commencement of cyclone or before reaching it. People, those who are living at the coastal region, they should always listen to the TV or radio news and about the warnings, what is going to be happened, so that they can prepare or they can move from that area to save their life and property. And they should keep with them the stock of food, medicine, first aid kit, some clothes with them, so that they can survive for about 2-3 days till the relief people will not come there to help them. So they should listen to the warnings. And the cyclones can be reduced when there will be plantation at the coastal areas. More and more plantations are needed to check the flow and blow of very fast blowing cyclonic winds. The next is drought. In India, there are some regions, the parts of Rajasthan, the western part of India and the central part of India, which receives less rainfall. Sometimes in the western part of Rajasthan, there is very less rainfall, less than 20 centimeters. And therefore, there is very high temperature during summer. There is drought condition. There is scarcity of water. And there is the problem of starving. And therefore, sometimes that may cause of the death of the people. So the drought condition is caused due to the no rainfall or lack of rainfall, and also due to the very high temperature in India. So, how to solve the problem of this drought condition in the large parts of India? People should practice the rain water harvesting methods. During rainy season, they should collect rain water in the wells or tanks so that the water can be utilized for various purposes during the drier periods and dry seasons. Water can be used for domestic purpose, for irrigation, or for other various purposes. So, the main method to solve the problem of drought condition is rain water harvesting. Thank you.